To get started, let's introduce the 2019 seniors who will lead our team to victory this fall.
Welcome back to Pitt Beyond the Script, rejoined by head coach Pat Narduzzi. Coach, as we look forward to the game against Saturday, obviously a big game, really important game for the team, and I do want to touch on that in a moment. But it's also senior day. Before we talk about some of the seniors, what's it like for you? Because obviously you'll still see these guys, you still have a bowl game to prepare for, but this is an emotional moment for the kids, and I'm sure it is for you and the coaching staff as well.
Yeah, it is, Rob. You know, we will certainly see all these guys. I mean, Aaron Donald comes back, and I didn't even coach him. You know, it's going to be a, you know, obviously an emotional day. It always is, and I think the longer you are with these kids, you know, maybe the more emotional it gets. You've got more memories, and it's their last game playing in Heinz Field, so it's not a matter of just the last time you're going to see them, and then they're off and gone, and you never see them again. But it's their last game in Heinz Field. It's a game they'll never forget. And I think that's the important thing is you probably don't, you know, forget your last game as a senior in college. And these guys will remember this game for a long, long time.
I wanted to ask you about a couple of the seniors because these guys were early on in your recruiting process. Some of them were guys that you recruited just after or maybe kept commitments to just after you got hired. Other guys were part of your first recruiting class. I do remember the excitement, not only on campus and in the Pitt community, but in the Pittsburgh community at large when DeMar Hamlin decided from Central Catholic that he was coming to Pitt.
Yeah, I mean, DeMar Hamlin was obviously one of the top recruits in the area, and it was a great opportunity to have him come play in his backyard in his city and play home. We had some great visits with his family, just tremendous, family support he's got at home. You know, it's just fun being able to be that close and have their families come. And DeMar's a special kid and that's gone through, like every senior, the adversity that we've been able to get to watch him grow through the adversity he's had with injuries and then become the man he has today and be able to play the way he's played on Saturdays for the Panthers this season.
And Dane Jackson, another local guy who's a captain on the team.
Yeah, I mean, Dane is a captain, great leader, mature. Really didn't go through the same adversity that DeMar Hamlin went through, but a guy that's just every year just gotten better and a guy that you can count on every Saturday that was there. He's played a lot of football games and has been a mainstay in this defense for a long time.
Saleem Brightwell, Maurice French, I mean, I could go on and on, Coach, but when you see guys, and not all of them are 4 or 5-star recruits, but when they progress, whether it is just a little bit because they're already a 4 or 5-star recruit or a lot because they just have more learning to do, more training, more tutelage needed. What's it like when you see these guys now coming out to play their final home game at Heinz Field?
It's amazing. I mean, you mentioned 2 Jersey guys. We talked about 2 Pittsburgh natives, and then we talked about our 2 New Jersey guys, Saleem Brightwell and Maurice French. Again, Saleem was a guy that was recruited at Michigan State when I left, and we kind of got him, to come to Pittsburgh. And you watch the way he's leading our defense this year. I mean, he's been the Mike, majority of the season, and he's just taken that role, and he's become a bigger and better leader as the season's gone on. So it's fun to watch those guys develop. Maurice French, he was recruited as a DB, and now he's got 70-some catches, in his senior year. And he still wants to play defense. I think he wants to play defense this week. He wants to play both ways if he could. He's asking when he's going to get a shot. Just to watch those guys develop, and you never know what's around the next turn. You think about a DB that's now a receiver and one of the top receivers in the nation right now.
When you look at where your program is, back then I think you were selling hope and a new beginning. Now you can sell, you won a Coastal Division last year, you win this game, you have a chance to get to 8, then maybe a chance to get to 9 wins. Do you feel the momentum going? And part of that momentum starting with your first 2 recruiting classes, these seniors who are going to be honored on Saturday.
Yeah, I really do. I mean, when you watch our football team play week in and week out, again, win or loss, success or no success, and you watch the guys we're playing with, I mean, our talent level has raised, okay? It's different than what we were playing with, when I first got here. And we had some great players, and Tyler Boyd and Juan Price. I mean, there's some great players, but our depth is different. We had those great players, but maybe there wasn't much behind it. But, the thing I see, and the hope that I see is that we're building a program. We've got depth at a lot of different positions. And when guys go down, we don't lose a whole lot at a lot of different positions.
You were asked an interesting question because I think a lot of times as we reflect on senior day, it's what, these kids have supplied to the Panther program. But obviously the Panther program can supply something to these kids. Really interesting question. Some of these guys might not make it to senior day because they have a chance to get evaluated for the NFL draft. And you had some interesting comments about what to do with kids who get evaluated as first or second round possible selections.
Yeah, Rob, after, you know, the regular season's over, between that period of time when we play in a bowl game, some of those guys may have some questions. And obviously the seniors are going to have opportunities and pro days. But what we can do for these younger guys is give them an opportunity to be evaluated by the NFL and find out if that's what they need. You know, if they're going to be a first or second rounder, Rob, you know, I'm going to give them a hug and say, let's go. You're going to have to do this. Even if they don't want to go, I'm going to push them out the door because they have an opportunity to set their life up for good forever. I think anytime you talk about draft status, in a first or second rounder, you can't turn the money down. They got to go. We'd have to push them out and make sure they get their degree if they are short there. And then, you know, and the guys that are third rounders or better should stay. And that's probably the hardest job I'll have is trying to talk, you know, them into staying, even though someone's in their ear saying you should go, but probably a bad decision, because if a lot of those underclassmen, they wait another year, they're going to be a first or second rounder. You waste a lot of money by leaving early.
You know, setting guys up for life is part of, obviously, the college experience. And whether you do it on the gridiron or off the gridiron, the Life Skills program, which is unbelievable at Pitt, the success rate of graduates getting jobs is just about 100%, which is an amazing, amazing thing the university can provide, again, for the football players and all the athletes.
Yeah, I mean, whether you're, you know, an NFL guy or you're, you know, maybe not an NFL player, you know, the most important thing is we set these guys up for their future. Their parents dropped them off 4 or 5 years ago into our hands as coaches to develop them into men. And really, they're now able to walk on their own feet and be able to walk out this door and walk into another company and be a big success for them as well. And that's our goal with Life Skills. It's also our goal with academic support. Our academic support's unbelievable. And that's why we've had so many graduates before they even play their senior year. So even those guys that leave early, like Brian O'Neill left early, he already had his degree and he left early and made good money.
And one final thing, you talk about families giving the Pitt family their kids. You have Thanksgiving celebration. A lot of the kids, obviously, most of the kids aren't going to be able to get home. What's that like to bring everybody together Thanksgiving? Because now this is part of their family, their extended family.
Yeah, we'll have a big Thanksgiving meal here for them, not on Thanksgiving Day, you know, earlier in the week, you know, as a football family. Thursday morning, we'll practice. We're even actually going to try to practice a little earlier in the day so they can travel and get somewhere. But we have so many local kids that will be able to get home. They don't have to be here till, I think, noon on Friday for that BC game. So, you know, a lot of our kids, you know, will get a chance to get home. We'll make sure, you know, all 115 kids have a place to go. They'll either go to their buddy's house for turkey. They're going to come to a coach's house, their position coach. My house is open. I take everybody. My wife just says, let me know when and what time they're going to be here and how many people I've got so I can get the right food.
Oh, fantastic. Great to hear. And good luck. Big game, obviously, Saturday against Boston College.
They're all big, Rob. Let's go get one.
Good luck. Thanks. Happy Thanksgiving to you as well, Coach.
Happy Thanksgiving to you.
All right. Thanks very much. And thanks to you for watching this edition of Pitt Beyond the Script.